Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be going through Fourier transform of f of x is equals to e to the power of 2t u of t. Guys, we have discussed all these problems, these type of problems previously, guys. So now let us go through this problem. So this is not a standard equation or anything like that. So we'll be just assuming whether we'll be first checking that whether Fourier transform exists or not. So just you need to apply integration from minus infinity to infinity. If you get the value which is less than infinity, then Fourier transform of that exists. So that's what we have just tried here. So integral 0 to infinity e to the power of 2t dt. So 1 by 2 e to the power of 2t. So we got 1 by 2 in the limit 0 to infinity. So somehow we managed to get infinity. So for that, Fourier transform does not exist. You can just blindly say that for that, Fourier transform does not exist, guys. So now let us go through few more problems on Fourier transform. This is one of the most commonly seen problem, that is cos omega naught t u of t. So we know that u of t, it ranges from 0 to infinity. So the integral limits will be 0 to infinity. We know cos omega naught t, we can write it as e power j omega naught t plus e power minus j omega naught t by 2. Fine. So we'll be writing that, we'll be multiplying it with u of t. So the limits will be 1 by 2, we'll be just pulling it off from the brackets, integral e to the power of j omega naught dt plus integral plus 1 by 2 integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus j omega naught t dt. So initially we are checking whether the Fourier transform exists or not. So after solving it, we have just got infinity plus something. So we'll be considering this part. Hence, for this, the Fourier transform exists, guys. So once you try to apply the main formula, it is almost similar to the previous formulas, guys. That's the reason why I'm just seeing you a bit faster. So u of t e to the power of j omega naught t. So once you apply, you will be taking the common t. Here we got j and t. Both are common, guys. That's a funny thing to hear. So in this also we got j and t. So in that way you took them outside. You did integration. So we got these two equations, this big equation. And now when you apply limits from 0 to infinity in both the cases, finally we are left with these two things. So I think I did mistake somewhere in this problem, guys. Okay, so this is the problem that I just justified. One of my friend told me that there's a mistake in this, so I'll be just updating it right now. Okay, so when you take these two common, what will be here, guys? It should be positive, right? So that's the major mistake that I have just did it here. Positive. So this will be positive. Okay, so this will be positive. So this LCM is not possible, guys. These two answers are wrong. Okay, guys. So now I hope you can solve from here. You'll be doing LCM, you'll be getting some result. Okay guys, that's the Fourier transform of the given question. That is nothing but cos omega naught t u of t. Okay guys, so I hope everyone is now 100% clear with this problem. So now let us go through one more problem, guys. Guys, this will be the last problem for Fourier transform. In the next tutorial, we'll be going through some theorems or derivations, whatever you may call, or some proofs. Okay, so or you can even call them as properties, guys. Okay, fine. So Fourier transform of x of t is equal to e to the power of minus t u of t minus 2. So in one case we got u of t, in another it is u of minus t, in this case it is u of t minus 1. Crazy questions. Okay, fine. U of t. Okay, x of t is equal to integral 0 to minus infinity to infinity e power minus 2t u of t minus 1. So we are just checking whether the Fourier transform exists or not. Integral 1 to infinity. So from this we got 1 to infinity, right? I hope everyone can understand using graphs, guys. It's really simple. So my 1 by minus 2 e to the power of minus 2t, the limits are from 1 to infinity, so we substituted the limits. So we got some random value, that is 0.06, which is less than infinity. So Fourier transform of that exists. So x of omega is equal to minus infinity to infinity e to the power of minus 2t u of t. So we can push it out by changing the limits 1 to infinity e to the power of minus 2t e to the power of minus j omega naught t. So taking t common, we can take 2 plus j omega naught outside. So we can take minus common. Okay, that's fine. So here we are getting, so minus, minus, minus gets cancelled and we'll be getting this as the result. This is the Fourier transform of given question. Okay guys, so now I hope everyone is now 100% clear with Fourier transform basic problems. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through the properties, the few properties almost. I'll be covering 7 to 8 properties of Fourier transform, guys. The most commonly seen question in the question paper is write any 4 Fourier transforms, properties of Fourier transform, and derive them. Okay, so let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.